Good day, everyone. Dr. Polaris here. The Salawa, meaning scary wolf, is a canine cryptid reportedly found in the deserts of Egypt. It is supposed to resemble a dog or wolf as tall as 5 feet at the shoulder. It has a large tail, striped fur, and pointed ears which appear oversized. A local witness described it as bigger than a donkey, smaller than a camel with a long neck and tail. The Salawa is believed to frequent sugarcane farms, which are very common in parts of Egypt, and it is said to hunt lizards and mammals for survival, and sometimes it is said to target people as well. Actual reports of this cryptid are, as usual, rather sketchy and vague. In the 1960s, and again in April 1997, stories circulated in Egypt about a mysterious canid dubbed the Salawa. The creature allegedly attacked several small villages in remote parts of southern Egypt, resulting in several injuries and even deaths. As most of the sources concerning these incidents are written in Arabic, I was not able to find out much more on the subject. A contemporary report indicates that one of the animals was killed by the residents of the Katamiya suburb and tentatively identified by local police as a hyena. During filming of a 2009 episode of the Sci-Fi Channel program Destination Truth, an animal suspected by the film crew of being the Salawa was determined to be a fennec fox. I'm not sure how anyone could mistake the tiny, shy fennec fox for a bloodthirsty 5 foot tall predator, but a hyenid identity is certainly far more plausible. However, this is not the most interesting aspect of this cryptid. Discussions of the Salawa online have frequently made comparisons to the Shah, an unusual dog-like animal from ancient Egyptian mythology. The Shah is usually depicted as a slender canine, resembling a greyhound or jackal, with three distinguishing features: a stiff tail, often forked at the end, which stands straight up or at an angle, whether the animal is sitting, standing, or walking. Its ears, also held erect, are usually depicted as squarish or triangular, narrowest at the base and widest at the squarish tips, and a long nose, often with a slight downward curve. It is normally said to be black, but may also have been seen as reddish. This creature has been identified as the animal of the god Set, given its identifications with chaos, storms, and the desert. Unlike other totemic animals, the Set animal is not easily identifiable to any animal in the modern world. Today, there is a general agreement among Egyptologists that it was never a real creature and existed only in ancient Egyptian imagination. The Shah was featured as a hieroglyphic symbol, used as a determinative when referring to chaos, particularly with words related to suffering, violence, and also for sudden storms. All of these link the animal back to the god Set. Set, also known as Seth, Sekhet, or Sutek, was usually depicted as a man with a head resembling that of the Shah, usually with a long, slightly curved nose and erect ears which were squared at the top. Occasionally he was represented in animal form as the Shah itself, although he was also depicted in the form of a donkey or as a black pig. Other animals sacred to Set included the antelope, hippopotamus, wild boar, crocodile, and scorpion, all of which represented strength, power, protection, or the wilderness. The Shah was also used as a determinative in the names of Set and the goddess Nut, who may be identified with Nephesis, the wife of Set. Anubis was also said to be the son of Set. Anubis was the god of the afterlife and mummification in ancient Egypt, and was depicted with the head of a jackal. Another ancient Egyptian deity with wolf-like attributes descended from Set is Wep-Wowet. Wep-Wowet was a deity whose cult was associated in Asyut, which was known as Lycopolis by the Greeks. Wep-Wowet was seen as a wolf deity and was often referred to as the opener of the ways. Although Set was originally viewed as the son and defender of Ra and the Egyptian kings, his reputation among the people declined along with the rise of the cult of Osiris. Originally a vegetation god, Osiris became one of the preeminent gods of the Egyptian pantheon. His worship stressed the role of Set as violence personified, the murder of his brother and usurper of his throne, who instead of standing alongside Horus became his eternal enemy. This view of Set was encouraged during the second intermediate period in Egyptian history, when the country was invaded by the Hyksos, people from Western Asia, with whom Sutekh became identified with. Set continued to be revered during the New Kingdom period. Several kings of the 19th and 20th dynasties had royal names indicating their devotion to Set, and these names were written with a hieroglyphic representation of the god as the Shah animal. However, during the third intermediate period, Set was deeply unpopular, his worship abandoned, and many depictions of him were destroyed or defaced. References to and depictions of the Set animal likely suffered a similar fate. In recent years, there have been many attempts by zoologists to find the Set animal in nature. Egyptologist Ken Moss has suggested that the Set animal is in fact the Saluki, as it is one of the oldest breeds of domesticated dog, has a curved snout and nearly identical body, and is native to the region. Further, when the Saluki runs, its ears and tail become vertical, and cropped ears are a common and historic practice performed on hunting dogs throughout the area. The Saluki is further depicted in hieroglyphs without a connection to Set, suggesting its commonplace nature among ancient Egyptian people. However, some scholars believe the Set animal to be a stylized representation of some other creature, such as the African wild dog, a pig, an antelope, an okapi, giraffe, or even an aardvark. Since Set was later represented as a donkey or with the head of a donkey, it is possible that this animal was the inspiration for Set. Others have speculated that it was a purely fantastic or composite creature which never existed in nature. This was the opinion of Egyptologist E.A. Wallace Budge. How any of this relates to reports of a large mysterious canid roaming the deserts of southern Egypt, I'm not sure. It is quite clear that the Shah was a hybrid composite animal that never existed in nature. It is more likely that the animal was simply a heavily stylized counterpart of the god of chaos himself. Set's outward form is also a composite, representing his position as the lord of the foreign, chaotic, and the untamed natural world. Reports of large, dangerous, canid-like animals can be chalked up to misidentified hyenas, jackals, or rogue domestic dogs. In all, as dubious as this cryptid may be, it has at least given me the chance to discuss ancient Egyptian culture and mythology for a change. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'm going on a seasonal hiatus until the new year, so I hope you all have a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. See you again soon. Cheerio.